Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome to the stage our final group of the afternoon, under the direction of Maestro Gary Nicholson, the Colorado Springs Youth Symphony.
Thank you. couple little fun little warm-up pieces for us this afternoon. Dances number 5 and 6 by Johannes Brahms are from a collection of 21 Hungarian dances that he composed for. He spent some time touring in Hungary with a Hungarian violinist, and he became enchanted with the gypsy melodies. And he was inspired by these melodies, and he put down these 21 Hungarian dances for piano. And they were so popular that he then started orchestrating some of them. And some of the others were orchestrated by other people, but they've persisted through the years from the mid-1800s to today. They are very popular. I had an interesting memory for me. Maybe you had to be there, but I'm going to share it with you. I was in Hungary, in Budapest, about 20 years ago, and I was walking around on the Buddhist side with the battlements and all, and on these battlements was a gypsy violinist playing number 5. And it was so cool to hear him play there in Budapest, Hungary, the Hungarian dance number 5. Next, we're going to stick with Brahms. We're going to go to his Academic Festival Overture, one of his great works. He never went to college, Brahms, but he was very, very successful as a composer. He was very well known and was thought of as the inheritor of the Beethoven mystique. He was quite good as a composer himself, Brahms was. He was awarded an honorary doctorate from Breslau University for his work, and he accepted. Then he found out that as a condition of being given this honorary doctorate, he had to write a piece for the occasion. So he wrote this piece, Academic Festival Overture. And it's interesting because even though he never went to college himself, he spent some time on a university campus for a while, a couple of months, working with this Hungarian violinist, Remenyi. And he participated and saw some of the typical college activities that we still see today, and that's drinking beer and singing songs. So he incorporated some of these student songs that he experienced when he was on the campus of a university into this marvelous piece. You'll hear different thematic material, and it all comes together at the very end with a great, great finish. It's one of the great finishes. So I hope you enjoy Academic Festival Overture by Johannes Brahms. Thank you.
Thank you.
by Russian composer Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov. It's from 1887. The Academic Festival Overture was from 1880. So around the same timeline. There was, around this time, a great deal of interest in Spanish music in Russia as well as in France. They were enchanted by the sounds of Spain. In fact, maybe you've heard of Carmen by Bizet, a French composer, one of the most famous operas ever written. So there was a great deal of interest. And in Russia, a composer named Glinka spent 2 years in Spain listening and studying and learning about Spanish music, and he came back to Russia and exhibited some Spanish influences in his music. And Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov was inspired by what Glinka was doing. Rimsky-Korsakov did not travel to Spain. He was just influenced by what he had heard and learned, and wanted to explore this style of music making. So he composed this piece, Capriccio Español. There are three works by Rimsky-Korsakov that are considered to be masterpieces. One is the Russian Easter Overture. Maybe you've heard of it, and perhaps I would think you've heard of the Scheherazade, the story of Arabian Nights set to music. And then this piece, Capriccio Español. Capriccio Español is a showcase for an orchestra. There are virtuosic solos for a number of the instruments in the orchestra, and it was set out to be a showcase for individual instruments, but it grew into something as he worked on it to be a showcase for the entire orchestra. So it's a marvelous work. There are five movements. I'll give a brief description of them. The first movement, Operata, or Morning Song, utilizes the full orchestra, as well as clarinet solo and violin solo. Then we go to the second movement, which is called Variations. It opens with just a wonderful chorale by the French horns, and you'll hear this stated through other instruments in the orchestra. Wonderful melody, it's much slower, it's based upon a simple folk melody, Spanish folk melody. Then we return to the operata, but with a variation in that. Now instead of the clarinet first, followed by the violin, it's violin solo first and the clarinet solo. Fourth movement, scene and gypsy song. So we get a big snare drum kick at the beginning of this, and then there are a variety of features for different instruments within the orchestra. Then culminating with the full orchestra coming in and getting in on the action and leading directly into the fifth movement without any interruption, the Fandango of the Asturias, and you will hear this introduced by the trombone section. Bum, 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 and that's the beginning of the fifth movement, the Fandango. So enjoy this marvelous work by Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov, Capriccio Español. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.